a type of beauty, white, not with color, that is racial, and that is the domination of the woman and many other questions. And I begin on this. Yeah, very well. Ahora. Bien. Good. I would like to speak on the Industrial Revolution. I said something, I don't say more, because the idea was the Industrial Revolution began in China and not in England, and it's necessary to rethink. The last moment is the passage from Europe to America. The last moment of the modernity is the Americanization of the modernity. And we are now in this moment. And that is the last instance in this moment. And we must now think the question of United States as the new face of the modernity is a long subject. I didn't calculate good today the time. I thought to do a criticism, a postmodern position, because we speak not on postmodernism, but transmodernism. Why postmodern? The postmodern movement began in 1979 with the book of Lyotard, a philosopher in France, The Postmodern Situation. It's a criticism of Europe from the point of view of Europe. It's the last moment, the autocriticism of the Eurocentric vision, but as such is Eurocentric too. And they criticize the idea of the reason and the universality of reason. And they say, we can't speak more than the big narrative. We must speak the small narrative, because the reason is a dominant modern reason. But this position is the scepticism. And destroy to the critical reason that we need. Because we criticize very quickly the idea of the postmodern. That opened the door to a new type of rationality. And that is a subject that I cannot expose today, because the modern reason is univoc. Univoc means a reason that is based in the division of identity and difference. That means if there is a totality, is the identity, and there is the difference one of the difference two. But the foundational moment is the identity, the same. And the modern reason is the European reason in the identity. It's impossible to do the dialogue between people that each has a universal identity. Because how I can speak with other identity? There is the incommunicability between words. That is the position of the communitarist, for example, in the United States. We work now on one other type of exercise of reason that we call, is a very traditional but it's necessary to rethink analogical reason. The analogical reason I can represent in this manner. For example, the concept of right or the law in the Arab world, or the law in the traditional thought of India, or in the Bantu civilization, all are the concept of law, but not are different in relation with what identity, but there is relation with a level that is common for the three, but not as identical, but as similarity. 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 In Latin was similitudo. In the logic of the Arabs or of the Latin philosophy. That means that there is a concept of law in the Arab world that are some similarities with the law in the Indian civilization or the modern civilization, but there is no difference analogical distinction. And in this case, when we speak one culture with another, we never can think the other has an identical concept, but the similar in the similarity gives me more flexibility and I can develop with the time more precise comprehension of the other. That means one culture of the South can do a dialogue with the other culture of the South, but they will not arrive to identity. They will arrive to a similarity. And that is the idea of the transmodernity. Now, I would like to do a more representation, and I finish. Transmodernity is not alter modernity, other modernity, the pure destruction of modernity. There is a dialectic between traditional culture of India, Bantu Africa, China, Latin America, and modernity. There is a dialectic. Because I would say, imagine a cone of light in the night, a cone of light. That is like the modernity. Because in the first period, Latin America was incorporated in the project of modernity, absorbed, and take many richness of modernity. After it's absorbed, Africa, the slavery of many others, after the Islamic world, after India as colony or of England, Southeast Asia, all this part of our culture was subsumed in modernity and absorbed. But we have many experiences that the modernity couldn't subsume it, remaining the exteriority of modernity. Here, the exteriority, that is for me a philosophical category, new, different. The exteriority that was not dominating in the modernity is our language, our culture, many economical experiences, other type of political too, structures, many things, the knowledge of our people, the physician, the medicine, etc. The question is first, have consciousness of the value of our own traditions. Latin America is too like a home, and we have the big whole tradition. India has a long history and has traditions, cultural traditions. Modernity is other traditions and absorb our. But to have a new project of humanity is not a question only absorb the modernity and develop an other modernity. No. We must develop a new type of world that we call pluricentric or pluriversal. Pluriversal. No universal. Pluriversal, like the analogy, one, two, or three can coincide and de la similitude, but the similitude is not what univocal identity, but is flexible and have polysemia, many meanings. How we arrive to this new type of humanity, where one culture, England, and one language, English, and one classical author, Shakespeare, will be imposed to all humanity, and we will lose all our traditions, and we were Anglo-Saxon. That is the idea of modern. No. The future world will be complex, never identical, but always more in the complementarity. How? First, take consciousness of the own tradition, but not fundamentalism that say our tradition, yes, and the modernity, nothing. That is essentialist, substantialist tradition, because the tradition is always a process. Today is different our Indian tradition from 3 years ago. We changed, but it's our. But the tradition is not substantial, but historical and progressive. First. Second, have a self-valorization of this tradition. We wrote now in Latin America a book, 1,100 pages, two colors, small types. The philosophical thought in Latin America, Caribbean, and Latinos in the United States is the first history of the thought and philosophy in Latin America. We didn't have until now. We have. We must know our tradition and give value. And that is the second, the self-valuation process. Third, we must do a dialogue with modernity. We cannot say nothing. No. We can choose the best of modernity and absorb, but we, not that they impose us, but we. The computer is a good instrument. We can absorb. So we can do a dialogue. Third. And fourth, develop our possibilities. And Latin America do it in way. But not only, we can do a dialogue south-south to five, to learn of the others. And that is a new experience. Begin the dialogue south-south. That is the first moment. The fifth moment is with these conditions develop our possibility in Latin America, Africa, Islamic world, a critical European and American development, but equal as the others, not as capital, an imperium, but as equal. India, China, to the pluriversal world. And that I call a new age. New. Like the modernity was a new age in relation for Europe of Middle Age, we go to the new. If this new needs change more, this type of exotic subjectivity, the range and power, give the symbolic meaning of the nature and not only quantitative. We must go to the reconstruction of community, do a system more human that don't destroy the nature and the humanity, and so on, so on, so on. Many changes, a new age. If we don't go there, we can despair. The humanity life is now going to the suicide in 1 or 2 centuries. The nature doesn't work. Now we see this question of smoke, but we will finish with the oil, we will finish with the matter, and we must go to the sun energy, but very quickly. But there is no willing to do that, because it's against the rationality of capital that is the growing of the rate of profit, and not the growing of the happiness of the life of the people. And there is different ethical and political and economical and cultural and aesthetical and gender and race criteria. We need to do all this together to a new type of civilization. That is not modern. We call transmodernity. One utopia, yes, in the sense that utopia comes of Greek book. No, no, topos is place. Yes, this society now has no place. It's beautiful. But it's possible. And if we don't go in this direction, we can keep the life, and the Homo sapiens will despair of the face of this planet. We go in the end. Walter Benjamin, a big philosopher in Europe, said we must put our El freno. Explain all that. as I thought, but I hope that you can read after and develop and criticize all that I said, because I have not claimed to truth, but I have claimed to discuss. And together we'll do a new type of thought that is the epistemological decolonization from the modern.
Thank you, Professor, for a very, very fascinating lecture. After a very long time, I heard something that was spoken in a classroom. Thank you so much. Now, coming to some of the propositions, you seem to be not only critical of origin and constitutive logic of modernity, but also critique of modernity produced in the West. Now, there are a few. There seems to be two sort of methodological epistemes through which one is open to the critique of modernity. Two epistemic principles. One epistemic principle would be critique of modernity produced by taking and departing from Marxism.
Produced in West, say in Lyotard, but you will be taking Koslick, you will be taking Gadamer more seriously. In that sense, what comes...
We need one street here, and they say how we will do the street in the land. And after that, they decided do the street and how should a member of the community to realize the street. And this person that is sure to do, they committed or they act as an obedient person because he has or she obedience to the people and exerts the power, and they call obediential power. And Evo Morales explicitly, he said as president, I exert one obediential power. When I listened this expression, I said, that is a new conception of politics. Hobbes, Locke, Hume, Kant, until Hegel and Lenin has not this clear concept. They thought more the political power, like Max Weber, as legitimate domination. Max Weber said, power is legitimate domination in front of the obedient people. Exactly the contrary that the Zapatists and the Indians that said the power must be obediential to the community. And from this obediential power that comes from our tradition, I developed all politics. And big volumes, 700 pages, and I confront all Rawls, Habermas, Carl Schmitt, Agamben, all most important philosophers from the point of view of this conception of our original people. That I took both. But that is the politics. In the economical level, is interesting because Marx, but not the traditional Marxism, Leninism, that is not the same. I know very good Marx. I studied Marx, I said, like a microscope. I did the commentary of the fourth draft of Capital. Marx wrote four times the first chapter, the first value. In the 1857, 1851, 3, seven values, not a small manuscript, seven values, manuscript 63, 65, the three volumes, Capital, first, second, third, and in the fourth draft, 66. And in the second edition of the first book, that was the fifth draft. So in the fourth of Marx, there is an evolution, an archaeological evolution. I did that very passionate, 10 years. And I said, that is valid today. But there is not many Marxists that know Marx. Engels didn't know many things. Engels. Lenin didn't know very much things of Marx. Marcuse committed mistake, and the Frankfurt School too, etc. So I can take a critical thought of Europe, but he did the critique of Europe, of the oppressed people in Europe, was the workers. That is a good perspective. Is the internal colonialism. To say, I cannot take all the critical persons, but some critical persons. And I can convene in our original tradition, because in the economical level too, we have the internal European scripture, but are many times. Arti- collider with the critique of modernity from the traditional point of view, and we must have the two criteria, and not only our and say, because Marx is not Indian, has no value. No, no, that is for me fundamentalism, and it's not the solution. The contrary is worse. Our critical of our tradition is folkloric. That is the modernity position. We must be now more intelligent and use the both questions. Very good question.
Thomas?
But in English. It's very simple. I'm interested in the extent to which the articulation of the philosophy of liberation and the philosophy of transmodernity in your part of the world has developed in dialogue with South Asian understanding of modernity. The particular example would be Gandhi. Gandhi, the Gandhian critique of modernity in Hind Swaraj, perhaps also Gandhi's conception of obedient power, to take one example. And a particular topic to finish is you didn't mention today, you did not mention today, technology. So in Gandhi's Hind Swaraj, technology is a big topic, so I am a bit interested in how you would relate that to this canvas that you presented. Thank you very much.
A 7-year professor in the design, industrial design school, and exactly the technology I work. I published two of Marx, one manuscript, 1853, that is not published in English, but we publish in Spanish from German. That is the technological historical manuscript of Marx, London, 1853. And exactly, I study very much the question of technology. First, particularly a philosopher in Paris, he said that the technology is a means of production and can be given from a culture to another and can be used in other manner in other culture. That means I can learn the technology of other people. And that is, for example, the Bronze Age, 3,000 years before the Common Era, all instruments begin to be in bronze, not in iron. In all the humanity of Eurasia, as China, India, and the Europe, they begin to use bronze. Didn't arrive the bronze America, because the Indian didn't know the bronze and the iron, that was exactly the weakness against the invasion of the Europeans, as are the iron and the horses. And that was the advantage of Africa and Asia, because they were all in the iron time. I would like to see him. You can. you ask me, and I cannot use it. That means that technology has some objectivity that can be used in other moments of the time of the culture, and that too we use in other cultures, because of some opportunity. But the interesting and the danger of technology is the industrial revolution. And that is too a very important question. How was possible that in one century and less than that, the Chinese people here, after especially England, did so explosive invention of technology. Why? Because the science was very progressive and was applied to technology. No, I think that is a result of the logic of a capital. You know that they, in the market there is competition, and that is the doctrine in math, the surplus value was relative, and the absolute surplus value, I can have more surplus value, that is not the same than profit. If I put more hours of worker and the worker works more hours and produce more profit or more plus value. But at right moment that the worker cannot work more than 12 hours because die. And there were in England people that died because couldn't work more. Now in this moment, how the capital one developed the productivity? That is by the technology, because the technology don't produce value or create value, but reduce the proportion of the salary in the value of the commodity. In this case, there is competition, and can have, for example, three enterprises that produce this has A of value, and I put an example, general, A of value, or I produce the table in 8 hours, the other produce in 10 hours, and the other in 12 hours. I say that is not so, but it's only one example. That does. A of value, 10 of value, 12 of value. But the price is the average price. That means the price of the table is 10. If I can produce the table in 8 hours, I have 2 extra profits. And here I lose 2. And in this case, this capital is disbanded because it was destroyed in the competition because the table is too expensive. This recover and can go, but cannot struggle with this other because the 2 of extra profit he can use for the publicity to improve the technology, it with the time destroyed to the other. And put A, the price, and destroy the second. That means, either you improve the technology, or you are destroying the market. How? In this case, this said, I have a low technology, I must do discoveries in technology. And the criteria of development of technology is not a technological question. It's an economic question, and it's the criteria is the competition between capitals. And because of that, in this 18th century in England, there is so much inventions. Because either you invent a new technology, or you are destroyed in the market. In the moment where I adopt a new technology, I have a monopoly, because nobody can compete with me. But the others imitate my technology, and we are in time with competition. And other is more creative, we create more technology. That is the positive aspect of capital. Because how you develop the technology in the socialist country? There is no competition. It's the bureaucracy that must decide applied one invention of one engineer for the market, but the bureaucrats have no problem if they don't adopt the technology of the engineer. And second, the engineer made a new invention, but the salary is the same. And in this case, it's not interesting to do any invention because I have not any profit. And that was the problem in Soviet Union, was not creativity in the technology, and the criteria to the subsumption of technology in the process of production was a bureaucratic decision. And the bureaucrats are not good. In this case, the competition in the market is better, but which is the criteria of the growing of the technology, Marx called the organic composition of capital, is that I ought to use new technology in the short time, because I cannot be Ford 1904 in Detroit and said, I will develop electric cars in 1904, and I need 50 years to develop the electric cars that are very ecological. 86 Ford is out of market because the General Motors destroyed Ford because cannot resist 50 years to develop ecological technology. That means, to defend me against the competition of capital, I ought to produce the product with less value, that means better technology. If this technology produces death, destroy the life, that is the problem of ethics, but it's not a problem of the economics. I do. And because of that, von Hayek, the liberal, neoliberal theoretician of Vienna, said the economy has nothing to do with ethics, because I can produce death, but I can grow the rate of profit. So the question is not the technology, it's the criteria of the subsumption of technology in the process of production. The problem in technology, in ecology, is not that the Green Movement said the bad technology. No, the problem is the capital as such. And that is the question. We must develop technology, ecological, independent of capital. We must develop food for our bodies, health, but food, out of market. Because if I would like to produce fresh meat as commodity, I put hormones to the cow to take more meat. And after that, I eat this meat, and I begin to have the hormones. That is because I need to arrive to have meat with less value in the market. No, I need to take the food out of the market and produce a good meat because it's for my body. And in this case, it must be organic, in more expensive, sure, but don't kill me. So that is the question of the Green Movement. They struggle against the bad technology and not the struggle against the cost of the bad technology. That is the bad criteria, but this bad criteria is the essence of capitalism. That means with the capital is intrinsical and ecological, and must we go beyond that or we will die. It's a problem of life or death. And that is the Marx. Marx called Tode Capital. Capital death. And called the human being living labor. Labor with life. And the humanity, through modernity, killing the human life. That is the question of modernity. And the modernity is one of the subsystems of capital, but essential for modernity. The moment, real socialism is another aspect of modernity. And it's perhaps most modern than the capitalist. So you, the total planification is the total mathematization, the total quantification. That's a pure rationalism, modern, more than the capitalism, the real socialism. That's well born. It's very good. We must invent something different in the transmodernity. We must go beyond capitalism and beyond real socialism with Marx. And we need to do the Marxist of Marx criticism of the real socialism. I think now we didn't do that. The Marxist critique of the real socialism, that is necessary to understand what happened in the new age of the humanity. There is many things question new. Because for Marx, the oppressed, the proletariat was only the wage worker. But now is the peasant. Now is the woman in the gender question. Now is the conscience. There is many proletarian, because proletarian is not exactly worker. Proletarian is the workers, is the oppressed people in German, or German, said Giorgio Agamben. And it is a denomination of many oppressed people in the many particular system of the modernity. The worker, yes. The colonial world, yes. The woman, yes. The right race, not white. And there is many proletarians. And we need the new categories and new philosophies. That is, that we must make a construction. And at this level, we begin to have novelties from the South. It's a new philosophy. The European don't do that, cannot do that, because they are in the center of the world from the North. We then see from the South with the poverty that produced the modernity. And they don't see each day that in the streets we have now the laws, enunciaciones, we say, the enunciations placed to the critique. Good, I think it's...
Shall we finish?
Or do
you...
Very important person. But exactly in this point of technology, there is a problem. We cannot go beyond. We cannot go to the past. If we go to the past, that is the impossibility. We must go to the criteria of the past, to use the technology of the future. And we must criticize some type of technology and improve another type. For example, if we begin to use the energy of the sun, that is infinite, practically, because one time in the millions of years, the sun will finish, but we will have finished millions of years before. That means the sun is the origin of an infinite energy. That is a good way to go to the technology. It's not necessary to go back, but go in the sense of the respect and not destruction of the nature. And in this case, yes, we must go to the back, to this holy nature, the sacrality of the nature, and the nature, we are natural. I say to my students, each atom of my body, atom, is so old, like the universe. Each atom,
in the sense of the physics, is so old,
like the universe. Each cell of my body that is alive is so old, like the life in the earth that has more or less 3,500 years, millions of years, because all that is alive in my body never died. Think, never died. All part of my body never died. When die, I look, it's not my body. I come from the cell of my mother, and the sperm of my father was alive. And this one cell, I am. And all my cells come from this life. I am so old that the life in the earth, I am a miracle. And I am the brother and sister of the reality in the science, not in the myth or the metaphors, in the science. We must respect the reality. That is, I think, the sense of Gandhi. But we can use the good technology of modernity and not the bad. And we must develop the good possibility, and in this case, not do a plan for the 4 years or 6 years. We need to do a plan for the 1,000 next years. And that's where a good plan to say, look, we will study to remain alive at least in the 1,000 next year. How to do that? There is criteria. But you might not think that, because tomorrow was at the victory in the competition and be more rich, but we die. That is not my problem. It's a problem of the people that die, because I am a rich person. The poor will die before. I will die too, but at least it's irrational. Francis Kelamer, a good philosopher in Latin America, said, the capital rationalized the world, but it's a totally rational rationalization. The criteria of the rationality is the improvement of the life. That is, but that is against the capital. And the people in Latin America, many times the bandits, when they robbed, the people said, la bolsa o la vida? La bolsa.
The bag of the life.
The bag of. And those the.
The purse.
The purse is Wall Street. And the life. The life.
Entonces, is the money or the life? And that has the two criteria. And more, if I wrote now, not now, 25 years ago, one book of Marx, and the title is The Metaphorical Theology of Marx. Marx was atheist, yes, of capital, not of the gods, of capital. Well, Marx was materialist, yes, that means relation with the life, not with the physical matter. Marx said, the nature of matter don't have any interest for this question. Perhaps it's a new island in Australia. I consider the nature of the matter of work. That is the materialism of Marx. What is the first? The labor, the subjective labor of the matter of work, that is the nature. Marx said, the first is the subject, because constitutes the nature as matter of labor. Without labor, there is no matter. It's an anthropological and productive sense of matter, not in the sense of physical matter. All the Marxist Leninism is absolute contradictory with the thought of Marx. We must rethink many things.
But,
continue it in this manner was a dream which has come true.